That's the best part of the picture right there. I'm crazy about that guy. I love him. I can't get enough of him.
How did you start in the film business?
I mostly like this. Yes, who is it? Mel Brooks. Yes? Well, I got free coffees here for someone inside. Can I come in? Then I came in and said, I got no coffee, it's Mel Brooks, I'm in show business.
Prepare your funny bones for imminent overuse, because we're about to embark on a riotous ride through the twisted, brilliant mind of the one, the only, Melvin Kaminsky. Or as you may better know him, the one and only Mel Brooks.
Sir Mel Brooks.
Yes, the grand poobah of parody.
Ship is too big. If I walk, the movie will be over.
The Duke of Double Takes. The legendary comedian who taught us that it's okay to laugh in the face of, well, everything.
The Lord Jehovah has given unto you these 15... Ten commandments for all to obey.
Whether he's upending genres, history, or just good old-fashioned decency. Brooks has a knack for leaving us gasping for air between guffaws. From the Stone Age... to the Silent Age, to the Space Age.
Oh no, not again.
He's left no comic stone unturned, no taboo unteased.
It's good to be the king.
And certainly no pun unpun.
Hey! The sheriff is a nick!
What'd he say? The sheriff is near!
No, God blame it, dang blame it! The sheriff is a nick!
So, tighten your toga, polish our sheriff's badge, and set your spaceship to ludicrous speed. We're counting down the top 10 Mel Brooks scenes that didn't just break the mold. They made a whole new one. So, are you ready to laugh? Let's go!
Number 10.
No! It's absolutely absurd!
I tell you, we must drive a wooden stake through her heart! Or else she will rise from her grave to seek the blood of the living!
Lucy was my ward! I won't permit you to desecrate her body in such a vile manner! It's sacrilegious!
But Dr. Seward, shouldn't we at least stand guard over Lucy's grave just to make sure?
No! I'm having serious doubts about this whole vampire theory. For heaven's sake, who in all of England, by the very furthest stretch of the imagination, could possibly be a vampire?
Count Dracula.
Well, maybe him.
Number 9.
Careful, Robin. You got too far.
I've only just begun. I've come to warn you that if you do not stop levying these evil taxes, I shall lead the good people of England in a revolt against you.
And why should the people listen to you?
Because, unlike some other Robin Hoods, I can speak with an English accent.
Tell you the truth, this guy's starting to get on my nerves.
Number 8.
Hello? Listen, mister, I don't go for this sort of thing. How did you, get my room number? I am not going to listen to any more of this. I mean, I've had just about enough. What are you wearing? Jeans? You're wearing jeans? I bet they're tight.
God.
You are an animal.
Number 7. Number 6.
You're gonna jump on me. Huh? You're gonna jump on me. I know you're gonna jump on me. Like Nero jumped on Poppaea. Ooh. Poppaea, she was his wife and she was unfaithful to him. So he got mad and he jumped on her up and down, until he squashed her like a bug. Please don't jump on me.
I'm not gonna jump! I'm not gonna! I'm not gonna! Will you get a hold of yourself?
Don't touch me! Don't touch me! Oh my God, no, no.
Number 5.
Before this night is over, one of you shall betray me 3 times.
No.
Master, how can you feel that anyone here would betray you? You who we would follow even unto our death.
Yes. Does everybody want soup?
Please, we must talk. This may be our last supper.
Hey, it's my first order. Oh, look, one little question, I'll let you all go. Are you all together, or is it separate checks?
Please, go away.
Go away.
All right, okay.
Yea, so you say. But one who sits amongst us has already betrayed me this night.
Who?
Who?
Who can it be?
Judas! Do you want a beverage? Try the mulled wine. It's terrific.
No! Leave us alone!
Go! Oh, go! Go!
Please. You're right. Jesus.
Yes.
What?
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 Yes.
Jesus!
What?
Yes.
What?
You said what?
What?
Nothing.
Number 4.
Now, here is my plan. And I'm glad we're not in my office or you would insist on our using the cone of silence.
Oh, I've already taken measures for that, Chief. I brought along the portable cone of silence. It was in my car.
Max, we don't need that. Besides, it doesn't work.
Look, Chief, according to the handbook, you've got to take some security measures if you're going to talk about a plan away from control headquarters.
All right, Max. I want you to talk to Badef, Nicola Darby, and Walenska. They were the last people to see Hubert alive, and one of them may have killed him. Now, I want you to find out how long they knew Hubert. Now, with your cover as music critic, you can tell them that you're doing a human interest story on him.
Is that it, Chief?
That's it.
Well, we didn't need the cone of silence for that.
I told you we didn't. Now, let's get this thing off. I can't get the lock open.
Neither can I. Chief, I guess we'll just have to walk out of here with the cone of silence on. Max, we shan't go back to control like this. We look ridiculous. Well, maybe if we just act casual, nobody will notice.
Number three.
Pardon me, sir. I have an idea. Corporal, get me the video cassette of Spaceballs the movie.
Yes, sir.
Producers, 12 chairs, blazing cells, young Frankenstein.
Colonel Sanders, may I speak with you, please?
Yes, sir. How can there be a cassette of Spaceballs the movie? We're still in the middle of making it.
Oh, that's true, sir. But there's been a new breakthrough in home video marketing.
There has?
Yes. Instant cassettes. They're out in stores before the movie is finished.
Nah.
Here it is, sir. Spaceballs.
Good work, Corporal. Punch it up. That's much too early. Prepare to fast forward.
Preparing to fast forward.
Fast forward.
Fast forwarding, sir.
Pass this part. In fact, never play this again.
Try here. Stop.
What the hell am I looking at? When does this happen in the movie?
Now. You're looking at now, sir. Everything that happens now is happening now.
What happened to then?
Past then.
When?
Just now. We're at now, now.
Go back to then.
When?
Now.
Now?
Now.
I can't.
Why?
We missed it.
When?
Just now.
When will then be now?
Soon.
Number two.
I don't know if you ever heard of me before, but I used to be called the Waco Kid.
The Waco Kid. He had the fastest hands in the West.
In the world.
Well, if you're the kid, then show me something.
Oh, well, maybe a couple of years ago I could have shown you something, but today, look at that.
Steady as a rock.
Yeah, but I shoot with this hand.
Number one.
Good. What's the matter? Quick, give him the... Quick, give him the...
What? Give him the what?
Three syllables. First syllable sounds like...
Head! Sounds like head! Bed! Said!
Said! Said!
Said! Second syllable, little bird, this, that, the...
Said,
Said,
Dirty word! He said a dirty word!
Oh, sounds like... to give!
Said,
give!
Said, give! Give him a said a give!
Oh, tip! Said a tip!
On the nosy! Oh. Said a give?
Now, that brain that you gave me, was it Hans Delbrooks?
No.
Ah, good. Would you mind telling me whose brain I did put in?
And you won't be angry?
I will not be angry.
Abby someone.
Abby who?
Abby Normal.
Abby Normal.
I'm almost sure that was the name.
Are you saying that I put an abnormal brain
into a 7.5 foot long, 54 inch wide gorilla.
What?
Is that what you're telling me? Quick, get him up.
What? 3 syllables, yes.